Good afternoon. Today we will be taking up the last topic of Unit 1, which is Introduction to Wired and Wireless LAN. So in this topic, first we will focus on each of the terms individually. So first and foremost, we will take up the term LAN. LAN is a local area network that we have already studied, and it is a computer network which is designed for limited geographic area or short distances, such as a building or a campus. So a LAN can be used as an isolated network to connect computers in an organization for sharing resources. Now, most LANs today are also linked to the wide area network or the internet. So first and foremost, we have to remember that it is for short distances. Then secondly, it is used in campus and buildings, office buildings basically. And it is used for sharing of resources. And the next thing is, LAN itself will be connected to WAN. So LAN is connected to WAN. Okay. Now, after that, we have the technologies which are used for creating a local area network. Those technologies are Ethernet, token ring, token bus, ATM LAN, etc. Now, each of them individually, so the most common one which is used is the Ethernet. So Ethernet is basically the connection that is required. So a traditional technology for connecting devices in the local area network or even in the wide area network. So it was first introduced in around 1980s, and we will be studying that in detail a bit. So now we will be taking up the terms wired and wireless. So we have studied in detail about the wired. So we have seen about point-to-point connection, multi-point connection. Then we have seen the different kind of topologies. We have the star topology, ring topology, bus topology, etc. Now, what would be the wireless connection? The wireless connection is where we are using infrared radiations or microwave radiations to transmit the data. So here, in the case of LAN, we will be using both wired and wireless connections. So let's look into that in detail. So the first and foremost is the computer society, that is IEEE, started a project which was called as Project 802. In around 1980s, to enable intercommunication among a variety of manufacturers, like for different kind of computers or devices, to start communication or to enhance communication, Project 802 was established. Now, Project 802 is not a replacement for your OSI model or TCP/IP model. It basically specifies functions of the physical layer and the data link layer of the major LAN protocols. Now, so in the this Project 802 was later adopted by ANSI, that is American National Standard Institute, and it was also approved by ISO in late 1980s. So the relationship of the 802 standard to this OSI model is basically shown as follows. So over here, when we have our physical layers, so we have physical layers, then above that we have the data link layer, and then all the upper layers. So we are dealing with these two right now. So in this case, the transmission medium that is used, the transmission medium that we have for physical layer and data link layer has Ethernet in the case of physical layer. And in the data, in the case of data link layer, we have Ethernet MAC. Okay, so this is actually the media access control. So after that, we have another LLC, logical link control, for data link layer only. So IEEE standards have created several physical layers for different LAN protocols. So now after that, this is with respect to the Project 802. So let's begin with the topic. So we have seen what is the local area network definition, that is for shorter distances. and it is basically in a building or a campus, and LANs are by itself connected to WANs. After that, we have physical and logical LAN topologies. So physical and logical LAN topologies are those ring topology, star topology, etc. And then we have this medium access control, MAC protocols. And what are the common LAN systems? We have Ethernet, token ring, and fiber data distributed interface ring, FDDI ring. Okay. So now this is with respect to the wired system. So a local area network is a communication network that interconnects a variety of data communicating devices within a small geographic area. So it takes a small geographic area, which is like a campus or a building. It may be any office or building which needs network resources to be connected or resources to be shared. Then a local area network is created. And what is the advantage? It has high data transfer rates. Why? Because the distance is shorter and very low error rates. So earlier, this was an advantage of LANs, but now WANs, wide area networks, also have this. Now, since the local area network first appeared in the 1970s, its use has become widespread in commercial and academic environments. Okay. Now, the next thing is, what are the functions of a local area network? So the first function is it acts as a file server. A large storage disk drive is acting as a central storage repository. So suppose we have a storage server, then in that case, for storing the files, we will have a file server. Then the next is print server. So print server, it provides the authorization to access a particular printer, accept and queue print jobs, and provides a user access to the print queue to perform administrative duties. Now, the next thing is interconnection. A LAN can provide an interconnection to other LANs and also to the wide area networks. Okay. So, if we have two LANs, those two LANs can be connected to each other. That is interconnection. Now, the next is functions. What are the functions of a local area network? It transfers video. It has manufacturing support. And it also is responsible for distributed processing. What is the video transfer? That is, high-speed LANs are capable of supporting video, image, and live video transfer. Then manufacturing support is basically, LAN can support manufacturing and industrial environments. And distributed processing is, LANs can support network operating system, which performs the operation of distributed processing. Okay. Now, what are the advantages? Ability to share hardware and software resources. Individual workstation might survive network failure. So suppose if we have a workstation is basically a computer system. That is, if individually we have connected, if we have connected multiple computers together, then if there's some sort of network failure and loss of data, then since we have a central repository, we might not lose the data. Then component and system evolution are possible. And support for heterogeneous forms of hardware and software, access to other LANs and WANs, private ownership, success, secure transfer at high speeds with low error rates. So now, this is a local area network interconnecting another local area network, the internet and the mainframe computer. So we have first LAN one. It connects a computer and it is connected to a central server or a mainframe. That is connected to another local area network with a bridge route, or it is connected to a router. And then LAN 2 is connected to the router and to individual workstations and the internet. Now, what is the disadvantages of a local area network? Equipment and support can be costly. Level of maintenance continues to grow. Okay. So if we are providing multiple LANs, then the equipment will as we increase the number of workstations and the connections between them, that will become costlier. And also each network, each connection needs to be maintained. So maintenance will also be a huge problem. And what about the ownership? Who is responsible or who needs to take care about the LAN? And some types of hardware may not interoperate. That is, some types of hardware may not particularly be communicating with each other. And just because a LAN can support two different kind of packages does not mean the data can change, it can interchange easily. So So Elan is strong as its weakest link, and there are many links. Okay, so now suppose if we have multiple links, then if there is one link which is lost, then the LAN will become weaker, or basically if there is one link which is which transfers data at a lower rate, then it will affect the entire LAN. Now with respect to the wireless topology, so wireless topology actually in the past few years, wireless LANs have come into existence, and they occupy some part of the market. Now the principal technologies for wireless are basically we use infrared, and then red spectrum, and also narrow band microwave. Now whenever we are talking about wireless LANs, basically we have the three standards. One is we have the standard IEEE 802.11, which is a standard which defines the set of services and physical layer options for wireless LANs, and it includes managing associations, delivering data, and security. And also IEEE 802.11 physical layer includes infrared and spread spectrum over a range of data rates. Now basically most of the organizations have started using this wireless LANs instead of the traditional wired LANs. Why? To for the for, because it is better for mobility. That is, we don't need to have huge wires if we are connecting from one point in a building to another point, and then relocation. If suppose a computer needs to be moved from table A to table B, or from workstation A to B, then that is easier if we do not have wired LANs. Then we have ad hoc networking. Ad hoc networking. And coverage of locations which is difficult to wire. That is, suppose if there is a location in a floor which it needs to be connected to another floor, then it will be a bit difficult to wire the LANs. So that is why wireless LANs have started have been used more. Now, in the case of wireless LANs, the most prominent one is this one, IEEE 802.11, and we will be studying more about this. The standard. Now the next thing is a wireless LAN is basically it makes use of wireless medium, and this wireless LANs which started using in this in the last two decades actually, and the reason for this was earlier wireless LAN used to have high prices and the data rate was slow, so that is why it was not used earlier. And there was also a concern of safety and licensing requirements. But now these things have been solved, and wireless LANs have come into existence. Now, wireless LANs are basically, they have the cross-building interconnection is there. The applications can be cross-building interconnection, ad hoc networks, and also they can be accessed from anywhere. Next, we will be seeing the range can vary from 50 to 800 feet. But now with the advent of routers and modems, it has increased even much more. And even the speed has increased to very high speeds. Now, most wireless LANs include a wired LAN backbone. So usually, whenever we are talking about wireless LAN, they require some kind of back support or support from the wired LANs. And it usually requires a wireless NIC. Now, what is an NIC is basically the term is usually used when you're talking about computers. So over here, NIC is the network interface card, which is used or which is attached in your computers to have the Wi-Fi capability, that is. So now, next we will be seeing about more about the protocol. Instead of the details of this, so we will be seeing the wireless topology, and then we will be seeing the advantages and disadvantages of wired and wireless LAN. So with respect to this, let me do that in detail. Now the wireless topology, different forms of it are newer IEEE 802.11 and 802.11b, which is the Wi-Fi standard, defines various forms of wireless LAN connection, and we have the speeds up to 11 Mbps with 802.11b standard. Now wireless LAN basically is a wireless local area network, or it is also called by another term, which is local area wireless network, and in this basically mobile users can connect to the local area network through a wireless connection. Now this IEEE 802.11 group of standards defines the technology for wireless LAN, and for path sharing, 802.11 standard uses the Ethernet protocol. And CSMA/CA, that is carrier sense multiple access with collision avoidance. It also uses an encryption method, that is wired equivalent privacy algorithm. Now wireless LANs provide high speed data communication in small areas such as buildings or an office. And they also allow users to move around in a confined area while they are. So basically users can move around while using the local area network. Now in some instances, wireless LAN technology is used to save cost and avoid laying cable, that is cable, we don't need to have cable wires or twisted pairs or optical fibers. And it is also used for high speed internet access to the public. So wireless solutions are basically being used everywhere. And what are the advantages of wireless LAN? So the first advantage can be said as flexibility. So that is, nodes can communicate without any restrictions. That is, if, even if we have walls, senders and receivers can be placed anywhere from one room to the another room without having the problem of placing a wire between them. Then the next is planning. So wireless ad hoc networks allow for communication without any planning. We can have a workstation at a point A and point B without having any prior planning. And while if we are having a wired network or wired LAN, then it requires a bit of planning. Now the third is design. Wireless networks allow for the design of independent small devices, which can, for example, be put into pockets like mobile phones. And cables not only restrict users, but it also designers of small notepads. Okay. So if suppose imagine a world where we had to connect a internet wire for each mobile device, then how complicated it would be. So that is an advantage, that is the design, it allows the design for independent and small devices also, wireless LAN advantage. The next is robustness. So this wireless network can handle disasters, examples, earthquakes, floods, etc. Whereas if we have wired networks, then the infrastructure of that network will break down in such kind of disasters. The next is the cost. The cost of installing and maintaining a wireless LAN or a wireless network is on an average lower than the cost of installing the wired network. And also, it is easy to use. The last one is ease of use. So they are easy to use and the users need very little information. So suppose if we had wired networks earlier, not everybody could use the network without some kind of education or without some kind of instructions behind it. But now anybody is able to connect to the Wi-Fi or the wireless network and easily use it. So these are the advantages. You can remember the keywords and write the content according to you. According to what you understood by this now. Now the next is acceptable transmission ranges can be broken up into two areas or two service sets. One is the basic service set, that is surrounding an access point, and the other is an extended service set, which is a collection of basic service sets. Now what is a workstation? Workstation resides within the workstation, as I said, is an individual computer or a device or a resource that resides within a basic service set, while multiple basic service sets create an extended service set. Now, the next is wireless topology. So two basic components necessary are the client radio, or usually that NIC card, network interface card with an antenna, and the access point, which is an Ethernet port. So this access point acts as a bridge between the wired and the wireless network and can perform basic routing functions. While workstations with client radio cards reside within, so this radio card is your network interface card, and they are within the workstation basic service set. While this multiple network interface card can create an extended service set. Now, what is a single cell wireless configuration? That is when we have an access point and it is connected to the LAN, then that is a basic service set. So this is a physical device which is being held. Now, the next is the extended service set, where we need where we have multiple access points and they are connected to a local area network. So this is an ad hoc configuration. That is, we can have workstations placed anywhere, and this workstation is this workstation A is transmitting to all the other stations. Now, with directional antenna designed for point-to-point transmission, 802.11b, that is the Wi-Fi standard, can work for more than 10 miles. And with an omnidirectional antenna, that is which is antenna which is which can transmit in all the directions, may drop as little as 100 feet. So that is for shorter distances. Now, distance is inversely proportional to transmission speed. Obviously, as the speed of the network goes up, the distance will go down. That is, if we are providing the communication in shorter distances, the speed will be high, while for the longer distances, the speed will be low. Okay. So in the actual test, 11 Mbps 802.11 devices managed up to 5.5 Mbps. And to provide security, most systems use either wired equivalent privacy algorithm, which provides this 40 or 128-bit key protection. And also we have the Bluetooth standard, which we will study later actually. Now, along with this, while we are studying this, we can just have a quick view on the disadvantages of wireless LANs. First will be the quality of service, QoS. The quality of wireless LAN is typically lower than the wired network. So obviously, whenever we have a wired network with point-to-point communication, then the quality of service of the wireless LAN is lower compared to wired. And also, the main reason for this is the lower bandwidth. And next, we have the proprietary solutions. The disadvantage, that is, the standardization procedures are slow. And many companies have come with their own proprietary solutions offering standardization. So most components these days either follow the IEEE 802.11b or the 802.11. Okay, and the third will be the restrictions. So many governments and many government and non-government institutions regulate the frequencies of the network, so which is causing which minimizes the interference. And the next will be the global operations. So wireless LAN products are sold in all the countries. So the frequencies and all the devices need to be regularized. That is a disadvantage. Then we have low power. So devices using the wireless LANs are usually power consuming, and also wireless devices running on battery power. So whenever we are using the wireless network, then this should be taken into consideration, and special power saving modes and power management functions should be available. Now, the next is robust transmission technology. So if you remember, robustness was an advantage, but it is also a disadvantage. That is, if wireless LANs use the radio transmission, many other electrical devices can interfere with them. So that can be a problem, and noise will be an issue in that case. Now the next is, so we will be taking up a few more topics with respect to wireless LANs. So, and also there was another term which I had to explain, was ad hoc network. So what is an ad hoc network? So basically it is a peer-to-peer network. That is, many different computers can be set up temporarily. So temporary setting up of network to meet some immediate need. Suppose if you remember, in while we have our examinations or examination forms to be generated, a few computers are connected to a printer. So that can be connected as an ad hoc network for some immediate emergency. And this is basically, for example, a group of computers are connected together for the creation of temporary network. Now, whenever we are talking about wireless, there are some requirements to be met, or some requirements which are to be fulfilled. The first requirement obviously will be the high capacity or high speed. Okay, then the next will be ability to cover short distances. And next is full connectivity among all the devices which are present in the campus or the building. And also we need a broadcast capability. So these are the requirements whenever we are considering about wireless LANs. So in addition to this, there are a number of requirements specific to the wireless. That is, one will be the throughput. That is, the protocol should be used the maximum capacity available in the wireless network. And the wireless network should be able to support the multiple number of nodes. And there should be a connection to the wired network. As I said, there is a background support or a backbone for wired network. Now, also along with that, the service area, it should have some kind of typical coverage area. Battery power consumption is another requirement. That is, the devices which are using the wireless LAN should have a battery powered workstation and a long battery life. And dynamic configuration, that is the addressing and the network management of the wireless network, should be dynamic. And so with this, we will conclude our unit one. So this is the last topic of unit one. And the next unit will begin it tomorrow. So for now, I'll conclude the unit one.